guys, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. I had a story to tell you guys. It's been crossing my mind the past couple of weeks. I thought today might as well spit it out. Well, you guys know what to do, like, subscribe, all that stuff. This story I'm about to tell you occurred on December 26, 2017. Just a little bit after Christmas, and I was pretty heavy in the fentanyl trade. I had a cousin there, that was there helping me count some cash. They were counting up 20 grand. We're using some of the machinery here, so the cabinet, so which brought me to thinking about it. They were using the machine, they were counting up some cash, we're having some spaghetti, and we had something to eat. He needed some socks, so you know, a bunch of socks laying around, so he has some new socks. He said, "I'm gonna go check out my girl, I'll be back." I told him, "Right, yeah, come check me out, you know, I'll just be here, you know. I'm gonna re-up tonight, come see me." He says, "Yeah, for sure, I'll be back." So he heads up, he's gone for a couple hours, and then everyone's at my house. There's five people at my house. There's Rennie, Vaughn, Stomper, Binky, Peggy, and mind you not that, you know, Binky and these people mentioned they're close to me, you know, supposed to be close to me. I think about the story, you know, I got love for them, you know, if you guys see this video, you know, I love you guys, you know, but you know, this is the story, is what it is, right? This guy comes running in with a mask. He has a machete. And I'm thinking it's a joke. "Yo, where's your fucking cash? Where's your cash? Where's your fucking cash?" I said, "Cash, what the hell are you talking about?" And I had $20,000 in my pocket here in my sweater. And he says, "I know you got some cash in here." I'm like, "Fuck, what the fuck's going on?" And I looked back to everybody. Everybody's just like shocked, you know. So everyone starts running out as they can. Bam, bam, bam. A couple run out the door. Some would jump up two stories down to the floor. Point being, everybody left. Everybody took off on me, you know. And then I'm left there with this guy and this girl that are machete, so he comes running at me. I grab his face mask, because he has a face mask on. It's my cousin. I'm like, "Bam, wow, man, you, what's going on, man?" He's like, "I need that money, where's that money?" I said, "I got no cash, man. Girl can't pick it up, I'm doing a re-up, you know what's going on." Grabs my sweater, throws it over. The money curls up in the jacket, and he throws it over the couch. The money was in the jacket. So the girl yells and screams out, "I find it! I found it!" You know, I'm thinking, what did she find? You know. He runs back to me, slashes me, as if my hand goes, "Shh, this is where I go." I still got my, thank God, I still got feeling it. Panic. The guy thought that he cut my throat, that's why he ran out. My own cousin did that. You know, and when you're in the drug game, you can't trust nobody, not even your family. Like I said, my family ran out. They ran out as fast as they could, save their own lives. left me to die. Even my own brother, RJ, says that, oh, I can't leave my girl, I had to take her. You know, you could have come save me, man. Says, oh, you had some skates in the car, I wanted to use them. But why didn't you, man? Yeah, no, I don't really. You know, that's one of my stories about drug trade, you know. It's what it is, you know. This is one of my drug tales. I may be able to do some more, you know. But, yeah, you know, that the moral of my story is, when you sell drugs, you know, you can't trust anybody in your family. Even when it comes to death. You know, so, you know, if whoever hears this video, you know, check it out. You know, I have a lot more of these stories coming. Peace out.